China has very clear goals. China, the Chinese play a board game called Weiqi, W-E-I-Q-I, Weiqi. It's called the basically encirclement board. So the way the game is played is that you try to encircle your opponent on the board with putting your pieces, and the opponent is trying to avoid being encircled while encircling you. And they have long-term plans. There's a wonderful book which I commend to a lot of people here. It's by a colleague of mine by the name of Michael Pillsbury, and his book is called A 100-Year Marathon. And he bases it on a document that was composed in the Chinese Communist Party way back in 1949. That by 2049, China will have done this. And we will have become the world's ascendant power, and we'll do it by not going to war, or trying not to go to war. To think that somebody can have a 100-year plan, considering that we don't have even 5 or 8 year plans. You know, in America, when somebody says that this is the long term, what they mean is the next year, 8 years. In China, they're talking about short term, 100 years. So they have a different mindset here. And so they already have this game in their mind, and in that, they have already resolved that the best trick for them to become an economic major power and also a military superpower later on, with when you have the economic wherewithal, then you can have the military wherewithal. You can buy anything, you can build it. That the potential, who are the potential competitors? So economic competitors would be America and Japan. And in military manpower, the only country that has a billion people other than China is India. So they've always thought it, and they've thought it long term. And in that long term thinking, they've thought, okay, how do we tie down Japan? We encourage North Korea. China doesn't have any love lost for North Korea. You know, they don't like the Kim dynasty any more than the rest of the world. But North Korea keeps South Korea and Japan tied down. All their energies are spent worrying about North Korea before they can start thinking about China. And for India, they realized after the 1965 war that Pakistan military is obsessed with India, so why don't we encourage the obsession and keep India tied down with Pakistan? If Pakistan and India had normal relations, then China would have to worry about 400, 500,000 Indian troops who would be free to focus on China. And so, that is the long-term game of the Chinese. It doesn't get affected by those empires.